Well, technically, my entire documentary is kind of illegal because you're not supposed to go into these abandoned buildings, but that's the thrill. So, no trespassing. Exploring abandoned buildings. Everybody kind of has that fantasy of, or the dream where they find an old abandoned building and maybe like some treasure or something, and it tends to appeal to everybody, or like history buffs and architecture buffs. There's a little bit for everybody. How long setup and multiple takes take? Well, it's all South Florida, except, you know, the Chinese theme park's in Orlando, but I feel like, you know, there's so many places here that are like forgotten, or, you know, like the Amertech building that was in Hialeah until recently, that one got leveled. I like to tell stories, whether they're fiction or, you know, these little quirky documentaries and obscure things that, you know, other people might not know about. Zoolander, I quote it all the time, maybe too much. Orange mocha frappuccinos. It's hard. It's hard being a local filmmaker, but these are the stories that I really want to tell. I don't really want to go to LA and make a Hollywood blockbuster. So it's interesting. Tell what you know and passion driven. If you're not feeling it, it's gonna show.
This project is supported in part by an award from the National Endowment for the Arts on the web at arts.gov and by the following: South Florida PBS Arts Challenge, Arts Center South Florida, Lydia Harrison, Alfred Lewis, the Dunspaugh Dalton Foundation.